Three Truths and a Lie. Who among you have read that book? Three Truths and a Lie. Don't read it. That is my recommendation. Three Truths and a Lie. But I want you to listen to this sermon because this is different from the book. Amen? Amen. Praise the Lord. Number one, first truth that God has revealed to us. Marriage is sacred because God Himself sanctified it. In Ephesians 5:31-33, as the scripture says, for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and unite with his wife, and the two will become one. There is a deep secret truth revealed in the scripture, and I want you to listen to this. A lot of people, they will read the first verse, but will not go to the next verses and the church. But it is also applies to you. Every husband must love his wife as himself, and every wife must respect her husband. Did you see that? Did you get it? Do I have to expound on it? Or it's very self-explanatory? Husband, love your wife. Wife, respect your husband. Please do not change it. Husband, respect your wife. And wife, love your husband. If God puts a period on something, it means it is definite. There is no way that we can change it. In fact, this scripture applies not only to us, but it also applies to the church. It pertains to the wedding of Christ and the church. So whatever Christ has prepared for the church, it ought to happen and it ought to materialize in our love between husband and wife. Jesus Christ presents himself as someone that is pure in love. Husband, you must be pure in love. When you say love, it's agape love, not eros, not phileo. The Bible is very clear. The word that he used is agape. Amen? The second truth. A lot of people, when they go to the book of Malachi, But then, book of Malachi is all about tithing. Can we change that status? Can we change that perception? Oh, Malachi, it's about tithing and giving. No. In fact, I love the book of Malachi because Malachi is one of the books, all the books in the Bible are straight to the point, but nothing more concrete and more stronger than the book of Malachi. I call this book without sugarcoating. Because Malachi, when God exposed the truth to Malachi, he called the people, you robbers. And this is what thing I like. Can we read it? Malachi 2:16. Read as if you just won the jackpot in the lottery. Can we do it again? What is with lottery that you become so... But when it comes to the reading of the Word of God, we should be energetic when we're reading the Word of God because that Word of God pertains to us and it will help us grow. I hate divorce, says the Lord God of Israel in Malachi 2:16. I hate divorce. Can you read it again, please? God hates divorce. But Pastor, some of us have went through the divorce. That's okay. There is what we call repentance. And there is some guidelines that the Bible states for people to go into a divorce. But later on, we will see a better option other than divorce. Amen? God hates divorce, is what's written in the book of Malachi. In Matthew 19, 7 to 9, let's go straight to the point. The Pharisees ask him, why then did Moses give the law for a man to hand his wife a divorce notice and send her away? And listen to what or how Jesus answered this question. He answered it and said, Moses gave you permission to divorce your wife because, can we read it all together? Amen. Can you read it with energy this time? Like the one we're dancing with. How's that? Wow. Can you read it with such power and energy? You are so hard to teach. But it was not like that in the time of creation. So that was not the design of God for people to go into divorce. It was not. I'm so sorry, I will be straight to the point. The Bible says, I tell you then that any man who divorces his wife for any cause other than her unfaithfulness commits adultery if he marries some other woman. Now, Pastor, so there's nothing wrong with divorce? No. We will reveal that later on. The Lord Jesus Christ mentioned something that he is willing to open, shall I say, his heart and his mind to the concept of divorce if one became unfaithful. Okay? But it didn't end there. Because there's another underlying principle that all of us should learn and master. And I'm telling you, if you will master that, if you will learn how to do that, you will be perfect in one thing. You will be perfect in love. Number three, the third truth. Marriage should produce children of good character. Yes, it is true. It is written in the Bible that marriage should produce children. Who among you loves children? Oh, I love children. I do wish my kids stayed like they were babies. They didn't grow. It is easier for us to control them, you know, and play with them. Now when we play, my son can push me around. He's taller than me. I used to carry them and, you know, sing with them and sing for them and send them to sleep. Now they're singing rap music that I do not understand and it seems to be noise to me. I couldn't sleep. It was so nice before when they were young. But as time goes on, you will realize that it is time for them to get married and produce children of good character. In Malachi 2:15, it is written, didn't God make you one body and spirit with her? What was his purpose in this? Can you please read it with me? It was... Man, sad to say, this verse goes to our wife. So make sure that none of you break your promise to your wife. If you promise her good life, if you promise her your love, please fulfill it. And it ought marriage to produce children that is real God's people, or children that are God's people. Children who are truly can be called God's people. It is our obligation and the obligation of the parents to have children of good character. It is our intention, or shall I say, no, not intention. It is our responsibility to ensure that they will grow in a righteous way. Last time, I preached about getting angry, but now, let us add something to it. The Bible says you can get angry without sinning. In other words, you're not supposed to hate. There's something that we call forgiveness. It is not anger that ends the situation. Anger should lead to forgiveness and repentance. But hatred, you know what? One thing about hatred that is so true, it always leads to separation. So it's up to us. When we see something that is, shall I say, rejectable or detestable, it is our responsibility to correct that. It is our responsibility to correct all the mistakes that we are witnessing, but without hatred, without hating anyone. Okay? You see, anger and hatred are two different things. That is why in the fruit of the flesh, anger was not mentioned, but hatred was mentioned. Do you understand? The Lord Jesus Christ get angry when he saw the people turn his father's temple into robber's den. It is out of that great love that he got angry. Now, arguments. It is common for husband and wife to argue. Who among you believe in that? Who among you are married here? Can you please raise your hand? Okay, raise your hand. Just keep raising your hand. In your married life, did you ever encounter any argument between you and your wife or your spouse? Every day. You mean every day is like your bread and butter? I mean, your argument is like regular. It is your daily dose of like coffee. Day will not be complete without it. Wow. You say, church, this is the great lie about marriage that we come to know and accept. It is okay to divorce if your faith, if your partner is unfaithful. The Bible says, unless. And the Lord Jesus Christ is very specific on this when he say unless. It didn't mean when you say unless, that is a definitive solution to the problem. He is just saying, there is this case wherein I will understand the divorce. But it doesn't end there. And that is not what he's saying. He's not saying this. That is not the best solution. As what he said, I hate divorce. I don't like it. But I will honor your decision to divorce if one is unfaithful. However, and I want you to focus on what we are about to say. Divorce is not required. Can you say it? If your spouse has committed adultery, can you say it? Please say it. Read it with me. Divorce is morally allowed, but not required. For many couples have been able to rebuild their marriages even after such a devastating blow. In other words, church, you should try forgiveness first. Because that is where the whole thing on the cross is pinned on, forgiveness. Even though you committed adultery, even though you committed murder, even though you committed those detestable things, even though you bowed down to idolatry or to idols and committed idolatry, the Lord Jesus Christ died for you on the cross because he wants to forgive you. Because forgiveness is always associated with love. Amen? The Bible is just telling us that there is a secret thing about successful marriage that we should always and often use. And that is what you call? Next slide. Love. Can you say to the person next to you, you know, with your eyes doing like this? Love. Can you say that to the person next to you, please? Love. Love. It's like this, Ate Malita. Love. Let's read what is love about. Love is patient and kind. It is not jealous or conceited or proud. Love is not ill-mannered or selfish or irritable. Love does not keep a record of wrongs. Love is not happy with evil, but is happy with the truth. Love never gives up, and its faith, hope, and patience never fail. Love is eternal. There are inspired messages, but they are all temporary. There are gifts of speaking in strange tongues, but they will cease. There is knowledge, but it will pass. But love? Wow. Love is eternal. Love says it all. You know, whenever I talk of love, I feel like, going into that, you can call me, you know, as a romantic guy, as a hopeless romantic, as what they say. But whenever I think of love, I think of mushy lines. You know that cute and killing line? I was listening to one of Kino's song, a Filipino singer who's now based in California as a real estate agent. And he's doing quite well, by the way. And I love his song. There was a song that he sang. Not my way. Huh? No, that is my song for you, but there's another song. Woo! I could not believe that I still care. All of a sudden, my whole body seems to fly. I can't deny the fact that you're the reason why. I could have dreamed of loving you once more, but then I couldn't believe it. I couldn't deny it. I'm falling in love. Once again. You know that feeling? Yes. See, I told you I can lead worship. I could be backup singer. You know, whenever I think of that song, it reminds me of that real emotion that you are so high in love. And you know what? If you really have the agape kind of love, you will always have that kind of sensation inside you. That whenever you go to a ministry, you have this kind of emotion. That you know, kids, you know that. When you see the BTS, Kim Jong-un, who's that? Kim Jong-un? Oh, that is the North Korean. No, who's that? Who's the handsome BM? RM. When you see that guy who's good looking, you just melt. Church, that kind of emotion, God invented that, or God created that in us in order for us to know the joy of being in love. And the Bible says that that love is eternal. You are about to renew your vows. And God's instruction for us, the reason why you are here, is because after so many years, you still choose to keep that love in you, right? See, how many couples? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many years now? 22 end of this month. Woo! How about you, bro? 20! How about you, bro? Huh? 9! 9! Huh? 5 years! Sold for 5 years. It's going down. But they choose, because after 5 years, they still choose to keep that love in them. That whenever they wake up in the morning, when they see each other with that face like there is morning glory on the eyes, and with this dry saliva on the lips, with that hair doing like this, you said, you know, you look beautiful. You will have. We will pray for that. That you will still say how beautiful you are, and I'm still in love with you. That is what we're trying to say. You know what is the meaning of love covers multitudes of sins? That in a marriage life, love will overcome whatever your partner did or detestable things that your partner had committed. We all should practice forgiveness and love over the right to divorce our spouse. This is what the Bible is saying. However, if, for example, you went through a divorce because your partner did something as the Bible allowed, that is morally correct. To the next generation, I would like to encourage you to practice forgiveness first. Because that is very Christ-like. As your parents, I have to teach you about forgiveness before practicing your right. Amen? Jesus Christ has the right to sit in his throne, but he chose to die on the cross. Amen? Because of this, I would like to call those people who want to renew their vow to come to the pulpit, please. Can we ask people to bring nice chairs in the pulpit, please? Music team. I will go straight to the point, okay? I just revealed to me. Church, when we were praising God and worshiping Him, God revealed something to me that has to be spoken. I don't know who is this message for. I don't know to whom this message is. Maybe it's one of your family. But listen to this. This is what God, all of a sudden, he just spoke, I want you to say this, and this is what I will say. Casinos are cheating you. And that's it. That is the message. Casinos are cheating you. Huh? You want to say that? Oh. That's the message. I don't know it's for whom, but casinos are cheating you. You can have a seat first. When you got married, who ministered to you or who instituted the marriage? Where did you get married?
In Alberta, commissioner.
Oh, a commissioner. How about you, Suzanne and Brother Andy?
A commissioner as well.
A commissioner as well. How about
Wes?
Judge. Yeah. Who is that? Is right. Wes is in Spanish. It's judge.
Pastor Jeff Wilson from LGF.
Amen. Pastor Jeff Wilson from LGF. So we have one valid that is going to renew his bow, their bow, and three that they consider they need the blessing from God. Anyone of you were married in the Roman Catholic? We were married in Roman Catholic as well. Yeah. We want to be included here, but there is no one who can officiate it. if the church can think of something, I would appreciate it. If the church can think of something, I will appreciate it. Because there's no one who will appreciate, who will minister it to us. Yes. I was married in a Roman Catholic, but never in a Church of Christ.
Excuse my understanding, but wouldn't somebody that knows scriptures like St. Adelaide be able to take and read the same scriptures? She's a believer in Christ, as are we all.
Praise the Lord.
And Vernon.
Praise the Lord. In fact, elders of the church can do it. So, can we call on all the elders of the church, please?
That's why you like holding a white chair.
No, no. We would like to call the elders and the pastors of the church, please. Elders and pastors of the church, please come to the front. Come on. I'm up. We're increasing in numbers. Praise the Lord. Woo! Now, there will come a time wherein all of you will marry someone. We were praying to God that we will be included here. But we couldn't find anyone who's willing to do it. But since we publish it in Acts, we were hoping that you will be sensitive to our need.
Amen.
But since Andy exposed it, are you willing to minister to us?
Amen.
Amen. I wrote here the things that you have to read. You don't even have to change anything. Except that if you want to say my name with a superlative adjective, shall I say, handsome pastor, it's okay.
You know, I get perfect on my name. Just about perfect.
Come here. He's right. It's almost perfect. Yes. So each and every one of you, I believe the Holy Spirit to lead you.
Amen.
Can we just bow our head? Heavenly Father, Lord God, I commit to you the anointing, Lord God, that you vested in me. Lord, you have joined, Lord God, many souls through this church. Now I ask, Lord God, that as you renew our vow, let the same anointing be upon the elders of this church and the pastors of this church. I ask then, Lord God, in your name, to minister to them so that they can minister to us. Amen. Pastor Ray, where is Pastor Ray? Yes. I do hope Pastora Joanna is here. Maggie, what are you doing there? Join them. You are called to pray. Who else? Come, Maggie.
We're doing just one couple at a time.
You can read everything there.
Yeah, for everyone.
Okay.
There's several passages there, so we can change.
I'll start with you. Okay. Well, as an elder in this church,
And under the anointing of God, I accept the position of acting as official in the rededication of this, or recommitment of this marriage. So for our pastors, Pastor John Paul and Annie, when you were first joined in marriage years ago, you did not know what life would bring you. You promised to love, honor, and cherish one another through it all. And while life has brought you both wonderful blessings and difficult challenges over the years, here you are today, having fulfilled the vows to love, honor, and cherish each other. And God is smiling on you as you celebrate your renewed commitment here today, and as you reflect on your life together as husband and wife, do you now wish to reaffirm the vows you took years ago?
We do.
I do.
We do.
Okay.
Oh, we do.
We do.
Gotta get a little closer here. Okay. I don't like talking to somebody back.
Okay.
Thank you. Pastor, would you two please face each other and join hands? Okay. Pastor, will you continue to have your spouse as your wife and continue to live in this happy, loving marriage?
I will.
And Pastor, do you reaffirm your love for her, and will you love, honor, and cherish your wife in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, for better or for worse, forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Annie, will you continue to have your spouse as your husband and continue to live in this happy, loving marriage?
I will.
Do you reaffirm your love for him? And will you love, honor, and cherish your husband in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, for better or for worse, forsaking all others, be faithful to him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Amen. Let's go back to naman. Balik ka ulit ako sa susunod na couple naman.
Okay.
Susunod na couple.
Tessa and Joseph.
Just hang on.
Next one. Later pa.
When you first joined in marriage years ago, you didn't know what life will bring you. You promised to love, honor, and cherish one another through it all. And while life has been brought you both wonderful blessings and difficult challenges over the years, here you are today, have fulfilled the vows to love, honor, and cherish each one another, and God is smiling on you. As you celebrate your renewed commitment here today, and as you reflect your life together as husband and wife, do you now wish to reaffirm the vows you took years ago?
We do.
Please be face each other and join hands.
Woo.
Let's go now to our renewal of vows ceremony. Giselle, will you continue to have your spouse as your wife and continue to live in this happy and loving marriage?
I will.
Louder.
I will.
Louder.
Do you reaffirm your love for her, for Jessa? And will you love, honor, and cherish your wife in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, for better, for worse, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Jessa, will you continue to have your spouse, Giselle, as your husband and continue to live in this happy and loving marriage?
I will.
Do you reaffirm your love for him, and will you love, honor, and cherish your husband, Giselle, in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, for better, for worse, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him for as long as you both shall live? Giselle and Jessa, on your wedding.
No, later.
Okay, later. Kevin.
So that's Donnie and Cherry.
That is Donnie and Cherry. Donnie and Cherry.
Donnie, when you joined in marriage years ago, did you not know what life would bring you? You promised to love, honor, and cherish one another through it all. And while life has brought you both wonderful blessings, difficult challenges over the years, here you are together, having fulfilled the vows of love, honor, and cherish each other. And God is smiling on you. As you celebrate your renewal commitment here today, and as you reflect on your life together, husband and wife, do you now wish to reaffirm the vows you took years ago?
We do.
Please face each other and join hands. Renewing the vow ceremony, husband.
Johnny.
I will.
Will you continue to have your spouse and your wife and continue to live in this happy, loving marriage?
I will.
Do you reaffirm your love for her, and will you love and honor and cherish your wife in sickness and in health, for richer nor poorer, for better nor worse, forsaking all others, be faithful to her for as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Why, Sherry? Will you continue to have your spouse as your husband and continue to live in this happy, loving marriage?
I will.
Do you reaffirm your love for him? And will you love and honor and cherish your husband in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, for better or worse? And forsaking all others, be faithful to him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Next.
Okay.
Okay, it's Andy and Suzanne's turn. I would like you to face Suzanne. See you eye to eye. 22 years, give them a clap offering. Same with me and my wife, 22 years. 22 years, you have still hair. All right, okay.
Just about perfect.
Okay. Okay.
Hey, you look awfully perfect.
I know, too. He's my long lost brother. Okay. I'll just read it in the screen. Okay, Andy, Suzanne. Direct to the eyes, okay? When you first joined the marriage years ago, you did not know what life would bring you. You promised to love, honor, and cherish one another through it all. And while life has brought you both wonderful blessings and difficult challenges over the years, here you are today, having fulfilled The vows to love, honor, and cherish each other, and God is smiling on you both. As you celebrate your renewed commitment here today, and as you reflect on your life together as husband and wife, you know, wish to reaffirm the vows took years ago? What's the answer?
We do.
Good. Have a little bit of kiss. Okay, that's enough. Now, please face each other again. Andy, will you continue to have your spouse, Suzanne, as your wife and continue to live in a happy, loving marriage?
I will.
And do you reaffirm your love for Suzanne and will love, honor, and cherish Suzanne in sickness and in health, for richer and poorer, for better, for worse, forsaking all others, be faithful to her for as long as you both live?
I do.
Kiss again. Okay, Suzanne. Will you continue to have your spouse as your husband, Andy, and continue to live in this happy, loving marriage?
I will.
Do you reaffirm your love for Andy, and will you love, honor, and cherish your husband in sickness and in health, for richer and for poorer, for better or for worse, forsaking all others, be faithful to him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Kiss again.
Please, next.
You now have a experienced elder. Did this once before, so this is a whole easy thing now. Anyway, okay, sorry, Wilbur and Glenda. On your wedding day many years ago, you exchanged rings as a symbol of never-ending circle that connects you to the eternal quality of God.
Go back, please.
Oh, yeah.
When you first joined.
Okay. When you first joined in marriage years ago, you did not know what the life would bring you. You promised to love, honor, and cherish one another through it all. And while life has brought you both wonderful blessings and difficult challenges over the years, here you are today, having fulfilled the vows to love, honor, and cherish each other, and God is smiling on you. As you celebrate your renewed commitment here today, and as you reflect on your life together as husband and wife, do you now wish to reaffirm the vows that you took years ago?
We do.
Okay, Wilbur, will you continue to have your spouse Glenda as your wife? That's actually kind of funny because my middle name is Glenn. I should be able to say that word. Anyway, do you agree to continue to have your spouse as your wife and to continue to live in this happy and loving marriage?
I will.
And do you reaffirm your love for her? And will you love, honor, and cherish your wife in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, for better or for worse, forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Glenda, will you continue to have Wilbur as your spouse, your husband, and continue to live in this happy and loving marriage? And do you next page. And Glenda, do you reaffirm your love for Wilbur? And will you love, honor, and cherish your husband in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, for better or for worse, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him for as long as you both shall live?
I do. Praise God. I was so happy that Jen and Terry came up to renew their vows because I think they're not really ready. But praise the Lord because this is the great time for them to renew their vows. Yeah. And we praise God for the life of Terry, who will be a living testimony for every one of us. So today, you will witness how love conquers all.
Amen.
And this is the real unconditional love that Jenny gives to her husband, Terry. When you first joined in marriage, Terry and Jenny, years ago, you didn't know what life would bring you. You promised to love, honor, and cherish one another through it all. And while life has brought you both wonderful blessings especially from God, it's Jeriel, and difficult challenges over the years, here you are today having fulfilled the vows to love, honor, and cherish each other, and God is smiling to both of you. As you celebrate your renewed commitment here today, and as you reflect on your life together as husband and wife, do you now wish to reaffirm the vows you took years ago?
We do.
We do.
We do.
Please face each other and join hands. As what Pastor Ray said, I think that is later. It's only Andy and Soa. They have the privilege to kiss one another. So look straight in your eyes, both of you, and put these vows in your heart. Terry, will you continue to love Jenny as your spouse and continue to live in this happy and loving marriage?
Will.
Do you reaffirm your love to Jenny, and will you love, honor, and cherish your wife in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, for better or for worse, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her for as long as you both shall live? Jenny, will you continue to have your spouse, Terry, as your husband and continue to live in this happy and loving marriage?
I will.
Do you reaffirm your love for him, and will you love, honor, and cherish your husband, Terry, in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, for better or for worse, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Can we call on all the people who wants to bless them? Just lay your hands on them, please. All the elders, can you please choose a couple that you will pray for, please? Person. How many are you? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah. appreciate it.
They will lay their hands on us.
If you are wearing rings, I suppose that you are wearing, you do wearing rings. I want you to remove your ring. If you don't have any ring, I will use rubber band. Married couples should be wearing the ring. I intentionally didn't say that because I want to know who are wearing the rings. Husband and wife, who among you are husbands and wife? Are married. Can you please show your ring? If you don't have, I would just like to encourage you. As a sign of your marriage, you should always wear this ring. That will ward off other people into, shall I say, mistaken you to be unmarried, to be not married, so that they will, you know, try to snare you, especially those who are handsome like me. I'm just joking. But it proves your loyalty to your marriage. Who among you has ring? Can you please raise your hand? Praise the Lord.
Okay, the husbands have the wife ring for their wife, and the wife has a ring for her husband. Okay, we're now going to have an exchanging of rings ceremony then. Husbands and wives, on your wedding day many years ago, you exchanged rings as a symbol of your never-ending circle that connects you to the eternal quality of God, unending strength and unending love. May you always wear your rings as a reminder of your vows to one another and your commitment to continue to live in unity, love, and happiness. To remind you of this commitment, you will now renew your vows. Husbands, please place the ring on your wife's hand and say the following words. Are you all ready? As you put the ring on, with this ring, I renew my pledge of love and commitment. Okay, the wife now has a ring to put on her husband's hand. So please place the ring on your husband's hand with the words that says, with this ring, I renew my pledge of love and commitment.
With this ring, I renew my pledge of love and commitment.
Marriage is a commitment to care for one another in mutually fulfilling ways. It is not an act, but rather a lifelong relationship that's always evolving. Marriage enriches each part of life. Happiness is fuller, memories are fresher, commitment is stronger, and even anger is felt more strongly. However, it passes away more quickly. The anger does. Marriage understands and forgives mistakes. It encourages and nurtures new life, new experiences, and new ways of expressing love. When two people pledge their love and care for each other in this way, they create a spirit unique unto themselves, which binds them closer than any words, whether written or spoken. Marriage is a promise made in the hearts of two people who love each other. The potential of marriage takes a lifetime to fulfill. Both husbands and wives have expressed how blessed they are to have enjoyed years of marriage. Their request is that everyone here today be part of this special ceremony celebrating their love and marriage. We would like all married couples to please rise and stand with their spouses. Can you do that? All married couples, please rise and stand with your spouse. At this time, we're going to offer a special blessing upon all married couples celebrating with those who have renewed their vows today. May each of you be blessed with the guidance, strength, and direction to make their relationship grow and blossom in the years ahead. May their home be blessed with joy and happiness, and may they strive together to make their hopes and dreams come true. Most of all, we ask that all couples be blessed by the love and the support of family and friends as they continue to live together as husband and wife, and from this day forth, they may grow more abundantly with each passing day. Amen.
Now we're going to anoint them with the Holy Spirit with Elder Nathalie.
Bless your marriage union in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. May your covenant renewal vows today be stronger, be full of commitment, be strength, the same as the
I just want to say, we're so thankful for this. The first covenant vow of the Lord was marriage. The sign of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit is the man, the woman, and the child.
Amen.
And there has been such attack of the enemy on the family. I just Amen. Believe today we have stood against the enemy's plan
Amen.
That this will go forth of a renewal, of a restoration over the city. And we just believe, God, you're doing a new thing. And the world will see that the Lord's wonder-working power to forgive, to love, to be restored is coming right now. So we Amen. Bless, we thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We now pronounce you man and wife under a renewed covenant, which is better, and you may kiss your beautiful brides. Thank you.
You may kiss the bride. Did they kiss? Did you see them kiss their wife?
Can you all stand up? Can you all stand up? And then, okay. It's Pastor Jan and Mary Ann Storn. You may kiss the bride. Giselle and Jessa, you may kiss the bride. Donnie and Che, you may kiss the bride. Andy and Sue, you may kiss the bride. Wilbur and Glenda, you may kiss the bride. Jenny and Terry, you may kiss the bride.
Woo!
Don't forget, after this service, we have a celebration down there. We have a very delicious lunch for everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, the newlyweds.